Hi everybody, Dr. Davis here. What I'd like to do is talk to you today about one of the 10 different steps of thyroid metabolism. You may have been to your doctor and been given thyroid hormone and so you're still experiencing fatigue and hair loss and brain fog, constipation, or even weight issues. You're still dealing with those issues and you're thinking, wait a minute, I'm taking this hormone. Isn't it enough or is it too much? Really, maybe I should be doing something else. Well, that's exactly what we'd like to evaluate and fix. We find out why your body is not working at 100%. After all, you're taking thyroid hormone, but you aren't really getting the results that you're looking for. Now, there's 10 different steps to thyroid function, starting with the brain and the messages that it sends to the pituitary and the thyroid gland, to hormone production with transportation and also conversion, and finally, how it's used in the cell. And of those 10 steps, there are 23 different patterns of lab tests and physiology that we see in the clinic. These patterns outline problems that can limit how the thyroid functions. Pattern one looks like this. You're fatigued, running low on thyroid hormone, and so your brain and the pituitary gland send out a message to your thyroid to produce more thyroid hormone. Your thyroid gland will kick into gear and begin making a lot of hormone, or T4, which is essentially inactive, and a very small amount of functional T3 to speed up your system. These go into your bloodstream, and since most of what is produced is inactive, not much happens. It's like your body's slow release mechanism. The T4 ends up in the liver, where the deiodinase system begins the conversion process of T4 to the active T3. Unfortunately, women are less efficient at this conversion, which is shown by the fact that women are much more likely, in fact, 8 to 10 times more likely to suffer the symptoms of a low thyroid, even when on medication. To further convert T4 into the active T3, it needs to make a pass through the intestines and the gut bacteria. The good bacteria make an enzyme called intestinal sulfatase that converts the remaining T4 to T3. So what I'm saying is that for this conversion process to occur, we need a healthy liver, a healthy gut function, and healthy bacteria levels. In this diagnostic pattern, the lab results will show a normal TSH and a normal free T4, but low free T3. Unfortunately, many doctors don't bother to do the tests needed to see if this conversion is happening, and this is what makes patients wonder, why am I having these symptoms if my lab tests are normal? So in my practice, what I look for in this situation are signs of liver stress or liver detoxification problem. And often we put our patients through a liver detox program in response to this. It's important that the liver is able to process hormones. After all, it's a big part of what the liver does, especially thyroid hormone. Then we look at what's going on in the gut. What's the environment like in there? It is very, very important that you have proper and balanced gut bacteria and that there aren't any infections that might compromise those good bacteria. We actually can test for that. So once the T4 passes through the liver and then it's passed into the intestines, most of the conversion to T3 has occurred. There are also other areas where a small amount of conversion takes place, like the brain and the kidneys and muscle. In addition, deficiencies in the minerals selenium and zinc from inadequate gut absorption can decrease this conversion, and certain drugs like beta blockers as well. Not only that, increased adrenal cortisol from stress and gut inflammation can block this conversion. And lastly, low T3 can actually cause gut inflammation, leading to decreased conversion of T4 to T3, causing a clear downward spiral of function. Now, I understand that this is a lot of technical talk, but this we know. It's important to have good liver health and good gut health when it comes to optimizing thyroid function. It's all part of the normal metabolic chain of events that's absolutely crucial when finding out how your body's behaving. So that in the end, you can feel good and have the energy, the body, and the brain you deserve. So if you feel that you could use some professional help with your health, just give us a call. And we'll start right away. Take care.